Hello, Custo community. My name is Ryan Majidimer. I'm a product manager on the Azure Synapse Analytics team. Today I'm joined by Henning Rauch, who's a principal product manager on the Azure Data Explorer team, for this episode of Azure Data Explorer 101. Today we're going to talk about network isolation. Henning's going to cover private endpoint-based security, as well as different security options that you can implement in Azure Data Explorer. I'm going to hand it over to Henning. Welcome.
Hi Ryan, thanks for having me in this episode. Network security is a very important topic for us at Microsoft and for our customers. Azure Data Explorer is designed to be accessible through public URLs. Anyone with a valid identity on a cluster can access it from anywhere. As an organization, securing data might be one of your highest priority tasks. As such, you may want to limit the access to your cluster or even allow access only through your private virtual network. This episode is about the options to achieve that. Let's go into the details. Let's start with the documentation. The best way to get to it is using our short link aka.ms/adx.security.network. Then you get to this page and you get the two options to implement network security with ADX, being A, private endpoint, the recommended one, and B, virtual network or VNet injection. VNet injection is based on putting all of the responsibility for managing the traffic on you, the customer, by injecting all of the compute resources of ADX into your virtual network. This is a very, very big responsibility, and private endpoint makes it very easy to get the same features as virtual network injection with the way lower maintenance overhead. You can also see a detailed comparison and recommendation in this table. And as you can see, private endpoint support inbound IP address filtering using restricted public access. They also support transitive access to other services like storage, event apps, even SQL. And it also allows you to restrict the outbound access. Now let's go into the details of a private endpoint-based solution. Let's have a look at a cluster. It's a pretty standard cluster. It has one small database called data, and it has a public URI for the engine and public URI for the DM. So far, no network security was applied. So if I click on query, I can go to the cluster. I can authenticate on the database. And then I can do stuff here, like querying a table, which is empty in this case. Now, as a first step, I would like to implement the restricted public access. In order to do that, I click on networking, and then you see public network access. Right now it's enabled, but I would like to disable it. And optionally, I could also define the list of IP addresses which are allowed to connect to this cluster, but I don't want to do this. So now I'm clicking save, and in a couple of seconds, the public URIs will no longer be accessible. This means if I click then on query, I will get an error by our interface that we can't connect to this engine endpoint because the browser tries to connect to the public URI, which is then closed. Now, the service was probably updated, and I'm going to check if I can still access the data plane by clicking on query. I get an error, but this is now absolutely expected because this web interface is trying to connect to the public query endpoint of ADX, and as we configured it, it's not reachable any longer. Now, in order to connect to it privately, I would like to create a private endpoint. So I click on networking, private endpoint connections, and click on private endpoint. Of course, I have to define the subscription, the resource group. I give it a name. I define that it's the resource.microsoft.cust/clusters. The resource is network security, the target sub-resource type is cluster. And on the next screen, I select the virtual network, the subnet, that I would like to dynamically allocate IP addresses. And last but not least, I have to configure the DNS SOAP. This will now create the private endpoint. Now that the private endpoint was successfully created, I can go to the resource and check the DNS configuration. And I see that there are two endpoints of Azure Data Explorer, one for the engine, one for data management. And the remaining six entries in this list belong to two storage accounts for blob, queue, and table. Now, in order to connect to the cluster, I will need to change the local configuration of my client so that I can establish a connection from my personal network to the virtual network on Azure, where the private endpoint has its IP address, like this. And I'm going to do this using a VPN from my network to the Azure virtual network. In the interest of time, I already did this before this session, so I can now go to the cluster. And check if the query interface is working again. Yes, we can already see the metadata, and if I'm querying that empty table and getting an empty result, and it's clear that I'm now connected to a cluster which has the public network disabled and the private endpoint connection enabled in a network which I'm able to connect to from my PC. Other interesting features of private endpoints in the context of Azure Data Explorer is managed private endpoints. Managed private endpoints is a concept that you need if you would like to connect to other PaaS services for various reasons. For example, making a connection to an event hub because you would like to ingest from an event hub that is highly secured. Or creating an external table to a storage account which has a disabled public access configured. Now let's try to connect Azure Data Explorer with an event hub that does not allow access via the public endpoint. So I click on add, I choose a name, give it event hub, select the resource, in this case it's event hub, the resource name is network security event hub, the sub resources namespace, and I can also have a description that I would like to get this connection approved. Click on create. Now the managed private endpoint was created. You see the provisioning status succeeded. Now last but not least, I have to go to the resource, which is the event hub, to its networking configuration, to private endpoint connections, and then you see that there's a new connection name. The connection status pending, the provisioning status succeeding. It's a private endpoint called event hub, and the description is please approve. In order to make that connection working, I need to click on that connection and say yes, I'm approving it. And once the private endpoint got approved, Azure Data Explorer can connect to that event hub privately, even if the public access is entirely disabled. Provisioning status succeeded. And now we can work with that event hub. Last but not least, restricting the outbound access is very important when it comes to security concerns like data exfiltration and the protection against it. In order to configure it, I have to enable it, and then I can provide a list of FQDNs which Azure Data Explorer can make callouts to. Such FQDNs could be from Azure Digital Twins, storage for external data, SQL, or web APIs. In order to show you how it works, I'm going to add the FQDN of our help cluster. So it's help.custo.windows.net. Clicking on save. And once the service was updated, I will be able to run a test. The update was finished, so let's check it out. Click on query, and I already prepared a small query which goes through the callout policy. And I can find a policy to the help cluster, which says, yeah, I can make a call out to this cluster. That's it, what I wanted to show you. Learned in this episode how to implement network security with Azure Data Explorer using our private endpoints feature. In detail, we were able to disable the public access, connect to the cluster via a private endpoint from a private network, create a connection to another PaaS service, an event hub, and additionally, we were able to restrict our outbound access. Thank you so much for watching this episode, and back to you, Ryan.
Well, thanks, Henning. That wraps up our video for today. Now remember that network security is just one part of the vast array of security options for Azure Data Explorer. There's identity, data protection, access control, and these are all equally important. If you want to learn more about security for ADX, go to http://aka.ms/adx.security to learn more. And tell us in the comments, what is your favorite part of security? Is it private endpoints like we talked today? Are there other things that you'd like? Tell us in the comments. I would love to hear about it. Again, my name is Ryan Majitimer. You can find me on Twitter. You can find Henning on Twitter, Kosh23, C-O-S-H-23, as well as Azure Data Explorer on Twitter, AZ Data Explorer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.